Well, today I will start my class with the first chapter, numbers up to 100. Now, before starting the chapter, I just want to ask you all, what do you understand by the term counting numbers? See, this is the term we often use. What do we understand by this term? So, counting numbers are the set of numbers which we use to learn how to count. Example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. These numbers are also known as natural numbers. Now students, tell me one thing. If suppose I have few sketch pens in my hand and if I ask you how many sketch pens do I have in my hand, how you are going to answer me this question? What is the only thing you need to do here is you need to count these sketch pens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So there are 9 sketch pens in my hand, and then that only you can tell me once you count it. Now we'll come to the topic, more or less number. Which number is more than and which number is lesser than? See, before starting this topic, I want you to know few symbols. These are the symbols used for more and less than. Now, this is the symbol of greater than, where this broader end is shown, that number is greater than the other number. The other one is lesser than, where the pointed end is shown, that number is lesser than the other number. And the third very important one is equal to. We often use this symbol, right? This is the equal to symbol. Now, I have made few questions over here. I want you to answer this. Take the correct option. Look here, students. This is an apple drawn on the board. This apple has some seeds inside it. Okay. Now, how many seeds are there? Whether these seeds are more than 10 or less than 10? How will come to know? We need to count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, 7 is less than 10. So, we will write here 7 and we will put a tick mark over here. The second one is, I have drawn bundle of sticks on the board. Now, this bunch of sticks, whether these sticks are more than 10 or less than 10. Again, what we need to do here is, we need to count the sticks, number of sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So, here we will write it. 12 is greater than 10. So, after writing 12, we need to put a tick mark over here. Not to forget, students, that when it is given, tick the correct option. You have to write the correct answer and then it is must to put the tick mark over there. Again, coming to the third question, we can see that few boxes are drawn on the board. And under that boxes, a pair of buttons are arranged. These buttons are arranged in pairs. What do we understand by pairs? Tell me, pairs means group of two. So, these buttons are arranged in pairs. First, we need to see how many boxes are there. In the first row, there is two boxes. Again, in the second row, there is two boxes. So, 2 plus 2, that is 4 boxes, right? And in each box, a pair of buttons is there. So, 4 into 2, Pair means 2. 4 into 2, that is equal to 8. So this 8 is less than 15 or more than 15? Very nice. It is less than 15. So we'll write 8 over here and we'll put a tick mark over there. Now again, the same way, the fourth question is there. The fourth question says that some boxes are drawn there on the board and on the that boxes, some stars are kept. These stars are again arranged in pairs. So first we'll see how many boxes are there. 1, 2 and in the second row 3, 4, 5. That means total 5 boxes are there, right? In those 5 boxes, a pair of stars are there. That means 2 stars are there. So what we will do? 5 into 2, that is 10. Now this 10 is less than 15 or more than 15? Very good. Less than 15. So we'll write 10 over here and we'll put a tick mark over there. I hope these things are clear to you all. Good. Now we'll come to the second topic. Our second topic is before, after, and between. See, this is very important topic and many a time students make mistake in this topic only. So here first you have to understand the number line. First we will go understand this two, before and after. Then later on we'll go to between. Look at the number line here. This is a number line. It always starts from left hand side and it goes towards the right hand side, right? It starts from 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and so on. See, listen, you can see here that the numbers are moving from left to right. When the numbers are moving from left to right, it is moving towards the greater side of the number. So, this shows the greater number. Okay, now when the numbers are moving from right to left, this shows the smaller numbers. Now make one thing clear to your mind that when we are asking about tell me the number after that number, that after means the greater. For after, every time you have to add one number. So after becomes the greater number. And when we are talking about the before number, that before shows the lower number. That means whenever you have been asked about the number, tell me the number before the given number, you have to subtract the number every time. So suppose looking at the number line, if I ask you what is the number after 8, what you are going to tell me? After 8, what do we have here? It is 9, right? And suppose if I ask you what is the number before 4, how you are going to tell me? Before 4 minus 1, it is 3. I hope you are getting to me. Now see here. Taking some bigger example. Suppose I take the number like 37. Tell me the number after 37. What we are going to do here, for after, what we need to do? 37 plus 1. Good. 7 plus 1, 8, and 3 will come as it is. Now tell me the number after 79, what we need to do? Again 79 plus 1, that is 80. 9 plus 1, 0 and 1 will be carried over to 7 and it comes as 80, right? 88, 8 plus 1 and then 8 remains as it is. Always make these things clear to your mind that whenever you have been asked about after, you have to add one number to the given number. Now, if we talk about before number, what we need to do here? Suppose the number is 15. So, for before, what we need to do? For before, we need to subtract one number from the given number. So, it is 15. That means 15 minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4, and 1 remains as it is. It is 79, then 9 minus 1, 8, and then 7. The same way, if suppose it is 66, 6 minus 1, 5, and then 6 remains as it is. Students, I hope these things are getting clear to you all. Please remember, see, we can consider only few examples over here. But in the book, many questions have been given, many exercises have been given. So please solve one and each and every question you have to solve. Okay? Now we'll come to the topic between. For between, I'll show you an example. Suppose I have three butterflies here. You have to, for between, you always need to understand the position of the number, the position of the object. See, here you can see I have three butterflies here of different color. Now, what is the position of green? It is after or before blue. Good. It is after blue. What is the position of red butterfly? It is before blue. Now tell me, what is the position of this blue butterfly? Where it is? It is in between red and green. So, this comes in between. This is the position of blue butterfly. It comes in, it lies in between red and green butterfly. Again, I'll show you one. Suppose I have three different color papers. Now tell me, what is the position of this pink one? It is after yellow. Green one, it is before yellow. And the yellow one is in between pink and green. Okay, clear? Now let us take the example of first three counting numbers. What are the first three counting numbers? Look here on the board. What are the first three counting numbers? 1, 2 and 3. This 3 comes after 2. 1 comes before 2. And where the 2 lies? 2 lies in between 1 and 3. I hope I am getting to you all. Good. I'll give you a few examples here. Then only the things will become clear to your mind. See, solve it now. The first question is, what number comes before 88? The second question is, what number comes after 99? And here, what number comes before 67? What number comes in between 26? Now tell me, what number comes before? See, whenever the blank is given before the number, that means you have to write the before number. The same way, if the blank is after the given number, that means you have to write the after number. So, what number comes before 88? That is 8 minus 1. Before, every time you remember, before means minus 1, after means plus 1. So, before means minus 1, that is 87. After 99, what it comes? 99 plus 1. 9 plus 1, 0, and 1 will be carried to the other tens and it becomes like 10. Again, before we have to write here, so 67 minus 1, that is 7 minus 1, 6, and 6 comes as it is. The same, 1 plus 1, 2, and 92. Are you getting me, everyone? See here, we have to write the between number. Now you can find it either way. 89, what comes after 89? That is 9 plus 1, 0 and 9 here. And this 90 is the number which comes before 91, right? What comes after 26? It is 6 plus 1, 7 and 2 remains as it is. And this 27 is the number which comes before 28. So, I hope these things are getting clear to you all. Good. Now, the next topic is forward and backward counting. In the last topic, I guess you all remember now what is number line. Remember that number line every time, because that number line only helps you to compare the given numbers. See, in forward and backward counting also, we need to keep that number line clear in our mind. Forward means what? Forward means number moving towards right. In the number line, of course. That means after number. Okay. Backward means what? Number moving towards left. In the number line, that is before number. Again, I'm drawing it for you. 1, 2, 3. See, this is the only number, this is the only thing which helps you to compare the numbers every time. So keep this number line clear in your mind. Again and again I'm saying forward, moving towards right, that means shows forward. Now after 3, what comes? 4. After 4, 5. After 5, 6. After 6, 7. So we are moving forward towards the number. If we are going like this, in backward, after 5, before 5, what it comes? 4. Before 4, 3. Before 2, before 3, 2. Before 2, 1. Okay. So, suppose you have to write the numbers in the backward form. And it is given 7 over here. And you have to write in the backward form. Now, how you are going to answer me? Just look towards the number line. Or you can do minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 like this also. See, suppose 7 minus 1 is 6. Then from 6 minus 1, 5. 5 minus 1, 4. 4 minus 3 already given. 3 minus 1, 2. So, what is the thing we are going to do here? we have to subtract a number from the previous number. Okay. See, from here we'll start. 7 minus 1, 6 minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4 minus 1, then 3 minus 1. Like this. In the backward way, we have to move. Again, 8. What we will do here? 8 minus 1, 7. 7 minus 1, 6. 6 minus 1, 5. 5 minus 1, 4 is given here. Taking the examples of forward, we have to write the forward counting for 11. Then, what will come? So, after 11, what comes? For forward, what we have to do? We have to add a number to the given number. So, 11 plus 1, 12. 12 plus 1, 13. 13 plus 1, 14. 14 plus 1, 15. So, you have to make these things clear to your mind that for backward counting, we have to subtract a number from the previous number. For forward counting, we have to add one number to the previous number. We'll take some bigger examples, right? Suppose it is 37 here. So, what we are going to write here? 37 plus 1, 38. 38 plus 1, 39. 39 plus 1, 9 plus 1, 0, and 1 comes here, 40. Then 40 plus 1, 41. Are you getting me? I hope the things are getting clear to you all. Again and again I am saying, many questions are given in the book. Please start solving it. You can do it. Okay? Thank you, children.